Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down.
Like to take a moment to honor a very special person who could not be with us today. Ryan's mom, Debbie. And we're actually video recording this for Debbie at the moment. So Ryan, Joey, two of you would like to look over there at Debbie. Debbie, Ryan and Joey want you to know that although they cannot see you, they know that you're here. Though they cannot touch you, they feel the warmth of your smile as they begin a new chapter in their lives. You have shaped their character. You have molded their spirits and touched their hearts. And they thank you. Did you wave? I didn't catch it. There we go. Good. First of all, Joey, you look amazing today.
Thank you.
Okay, good. Family and friends, as you can see, the lighting in this room is gorgeous right now, but I do have a word of warning. The purple and bluish lighting, don't stare at it too long or else you'll start seeing dancing bears. It happens. You know, standing in the hallway today, before the ceremony, I heard a little girl ask, "Daddy, why do people get married?" Now, I didn't hear the dad's answer, but I did hear the slap that he got from his wife, so I decided not to stick around after that. But you know, it is a pretty good question, and there are various answers. Love, of course. Companionship, sure. Perhaps a little break come tax season. But as I looked around this room, I realized something. It's the gifts. People bring gifts to a wedding, and they're awesome. But here's the thing, Joey and Ryan. You have given us a gift too. By letting us join you in this day of joy, you share with us the gifts of your love, of hope, of all the things that make life grander. You know, the best gift that we can give each other is our whole selves in truth. By doing so, we give them a true and accurate mirror that allows them to see themselves. We also give ourselves the best opportunity to grow. As the actor Danny Kaye once said, "Before we can give ourselves to the world, we must at first accept ourselves." Or, as my dad used to say, "A man who can give himself a hug every day, truly, has the arms of an orangutan." My dad was a weird guy. Joey and Ryan. Joey, Ryan knows that he can count on you to be with him during his highest highs and his lowest lows. That he loves the way you cry during movies and TV commercials. The way you make inappropriate sounds when you laugh.
He used it.
He says that you have a superpower. The ability to make even the most stressful of days dissolve into a giant blob of happy. Those are my words, not his. And Ryan, you are everything to Joey. This very independent woman knows that she can rely on you to calm her when she is stressed, to put your needs above your own, and that the kitchen will definitely look like a bomb went off after you've cooked. But these things are the real wedding gifts that you present to each other today. So share the gifts of your friendship, humor, vulnerability, sensitivity, and kindness. Be sure to find ways each day to protect, affirm, and support each other, and to treasure the balance and shared values that you have found with each other. All of us here, your families and friends, would love to be able to give you the gift of happiness, but it's not ours to give. You, and only you, create this marriage. So, travel the world together. Cruise to Cozumel, to the Western Caribbean, Myrtle Beach, or if you're feeling for something a little bit more exciting and exotic, Johnstown. Mm-hmm. But never stray far from each other in your hearts. Play board games together and invent new rules as you go. But never let criticism, negativity, and derision become the rule in your marriage. Ryan, I hate to say this, but Joey is funnier than you are.
Told you.
You're just going to have to accept it. And Joey, please leave all home assembly projects to Ryan. In this way, you'll be guaranteed that they will be built with the utmost care and precision and avoid all of the pacing back and forth. May the two of you enter into your marriage, believing that the love you share and your faith in each other will endure all things. May you always, always be in love. May you always have happiness with each other. Family and friends, Ryan and Joey have chosen to write vows to each other and to share them with us today. Ryan is going to be doing his through the art of interpretive dance. Ryan, looking into the eyes of your beautiful bride, please read the vows that you have written to her.
Joey, you're truly my best friend. I promise to give you the best of myself and to ask of you no more than you could give. I promise to love and cherish you in sickness and in health. I promise to keep myself open to you, to let you see into my innermost fears, feelings, secrets, and dreams. I promise to respect you as your own person and to realize that your interests, desires, and needs are no less important than my own. And finally, I promise to love you in good times and in bad with all I have, completely and forever.
Joey, hearing the words spoken to you by your beloved Ryan, do you take Ryan to be your husband? Do you promise to love him, respect him, and care for him under all conditions and circumstances of life, to be a faithful wife for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
And now, Joey, please read to Ryan your vows.
I don't have a clock. As I stand here before you, it reminds me how complete you make me feel. With every smile, every embrace, every tear you wipe from my face. It makes me remember how truly blessed I am, and that I can't thank God enough for allowing you in my life. It makes me remember every laugh we shared, every hard time we got through together, and every beautiful moment to come. I love you. You are my best friend. We prayed for you before I ever met you. You are the answer to my prayers. You are the only one for me. I love you, Ryan, and I look forward to spending the rest of my life proving it to you.
She wants to make sure you keep that. And now, Ryan, hearing the words spoken by your beloved Joey, do you take Joey to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, respect her, and care for her under all conditions and circumstances of life, to be a faithful husband to her for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
Do we have the rings? Ryan and Joey, may these rings be blessed as a symbol of your unity. As day follows night and night follows day, your two lives are joined in an unbroken circle. Wherever you go, may you always return to one another and the home you have made for each other in your hearts. May these rings forever represent your promise to each other, precious, perfect, and without beginning or end. Ryan, take Joey's ring. Place it upon her finger. And now, holding her hand and looking into her eyes, please say, Joey, with this ring, I thee wed.
Joey, with this ring, I thee wed.
And with this heart.
And with this heart.
I promise you all that I am.
I promise you all that I am.
And all that I hope to become.
And all that I hope to become.
And now, Joey, please take Ryan's ring, place it upon his finger. And now, holding his hand and looking into his eyes, please say, Ryan, with this ring, I thee wed. And with this heart.
And with this heart.
I promise you all that I am.
I promise you all that I am.
And all that I hope to become.
And all that I hope to become.
Joey, at this moment, I would like you to please take Ryan's hands and hold them palms up so that you may see the gift that they are to you. Joey, these are the hands of your best friend. Young and strong and vibrant with love, that are holding yours on your wedding day as he promises to passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands who will work alongside yours as together you build your future, as you laugh and cry, as you share your innermost secrets and dreams. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, and tears of joy. These are the hands that will comfort you in illness and hold you when fear or grief engulfs your heart. These are the hands that will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into his eyes, eyes that are filled completely with his overwhelming love and desire for you. These are the hands that, even when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you that same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. And now, Ryan, please take Joey's hands in yours and hold them palms up so that you may see what a gift they are to you. Ryan, these are the hands of your best friend, smooth, young, and carefree, that are holding yours on your wedding day as she promises to passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands who will massage tension from your neck and back in the evenings after you've both had a long, hard day. These are the hands who will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times. These are the hands that will comfort you when you are sick or console you when you are grieving. These are the hands that will give you support as she encourages you to chase down your dreams. Together as a team, everything you wish for can be realized. And these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you that same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. May these hands be blessed that we see before us this day. May they always be held by one another. May they have the strength to hold on during the storms of stress and the dark of disillusionment. May they remain tender and gentle as they nurture each other in their wondrous love. May these hands continue building a relationship founded in love, rich in caring, and devoted in reaching for perfection. May Ryan and Joey see their four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. Joey and Ryan, there is a song that speaks of a long and winding road. And before you met, your lives were on such a road, each going in different directions and seemingly leading to different destinations. But somewhere along the way, you took a fork in the road to a destination called love, and today you find yourselves standing together at the entrance of a new path that will join your once separate journeys into one. Ryan and Joey, will you now please join each other at the table? Before each of you is a container of sand. Each container represents the separate journeys you were once on. They also represent your own sets of friends and families that were once apart. I will ask in a moment that you both blend your individual containers of sand together, representing the coming together of your friends and family through your marriage into one. As the sand is blended into one container, your once solitary journeys will now be one of companionship as you walk a single path together into your future. Please now take your containers and blend them together.
I think about the years I spent just passing through. I'd like to have the time I've lost and give it back to you. Oh, but you just smile and take my hand. You've been there, you understand. It's all part of a grander plan that is coming true. Every long, long stream led me to where you are. Another's who broke my.
As this sand has blended together, your lives are now joined. Your friends and family are one as well. For now you will share those who are in your lives and will walk hand in hand along the path of your marriage, united and strong as husband and wife. With this box, you will always have the symbol of your commitment in your home, and you will remember this moment when your two hearts became one. Ryan and Joey, the vows you have expressed today, the rings you have exchanged, and this unity sand ceremony demonstrate your love for and commitment to each other. And now, by the power vested in me by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and before these witnesses, it gives me great honor and pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. May God bless this union. Ryan, have the two of you ever seen the movie The Princess Bride? Good. Now, it's not the part that everybody thinks it is. At the end of the movie, the narrator states that in the history of kisses, there have been five that have been rated the most passionate, the most pure, but this one left them all behind. No pressure. Ryan, you may now kiss your bride. Beautiful family and friends, please rise to your feet and join me in celebration as we greet for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan and Joey Morrone.
There's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so. And she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything. Must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday. But it's still hard to give her away. I loved her first.
Two stops. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha real smooth. Let's go to work. To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops this time. Two hops this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Hands on your knees, hands on your knees. Get funky with it. Oh, yeah. Come on. Cha-cha now, y'all. Turn it out. To the left. Take it back now, y'all.
She says we gotta hold.
Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 op. Op, Gangnam Style.